Anna Rogers. I'm the curator of the Bernice Abbott exhibit at the Fralin Museum of Art, the University of Virginia. Bernice Abbott's photography is a wonderful way to demonstrate to the public the connections between the history of science and the history of art. Abbott's an important art photographer, and yet she contributes these important images to science. She came from rural Ohio to New York to study sculpture, but in 1921 she relocates to Paris, where she meets a number of surrealists, and Man Ray, who's looking for a naive photographic assistant who will actually do the particular things he wants, hires her to work in the darkroom. Eventually, she returns to New York, where she creates her most famous work for the Works Progress Administration, Changing New York, which has really influenced people in documentary and in architecture education. Because she's already such a large figure in the art world, people in the science world don't entirely know how to take her. In her science manifesto, which is actually a letter to a scientist friend, she explains a lot of detail that she thinks there needs to be a new branch of science photography, and that that branch will provide the right kind of images for scientific pedagogy and for learning things in science. She creates the supersight camera. So this is an inverted camera obscura where it's a direct photography process. So she's printing something relatively small and relatively large film. Later she calls the camera she invented a ridiculous shed, but at the time when she invents it, she considers really seriously commercializing it. And this is pretty unique to have, first of all, a woman inventor, but secondly, someone who tries to bring the product to market herself.
A lot of her images require a number of people to work on them. It's not as if she could just go in the darkroom by herself and create these images. She's very interested in all of the action happening in front of the camera, not once you've reached the darkroom. And this is how she defines realism. Some people have a look at the documentary photos and think they're quite different from what she's doing in the scientific photos. But actually, for Abbott, she had identified the power of her time in both cases. And in the case of science, she's interested in staging images that show us something real. Through her science illustrated connection, she eventually gets a placement at MIT, where she spends what she describes as being the happiest years of her life, interacting with scientists and participating in group science work.